The lens in the eye sort of like starts to stretch up. When it starts to stretch up, we start to lose near focus. This and other effects that we have in our brain leading us to focus on the threat itself, which is normally going to be in intermediate distances, okay? So if someone wants to fight with me, from an evolutionary perspective, if I hear someone in a bush, or I hear someone running at me, or someone is yelling, normally speaking, he's not going to be standing here, right? My sights are normally going to be here when I'm shooting, right? They are here, but the threat is going to be always away from me. He's running to me, he's moving around me. And therefore, from an evolutionary perspective, our eyes are designed to accommodate intermediate distances. Oh, there is something in the bushes. Oh, there is some guy running towards me. Oh shit, there is something loud happening there. Normally that thing will not be here, it will be over there. Now, what happens with firearms is the following. We are trying to force our eyes away from the threat on the sights themselves. This is a little bit weird, isn't it? If I'm fighting you now, right now, it will be pretty much counterproductive for my survival right now to shift my attention away from him to my sights, isn't it? Now, logically, yeah, sure, we want to have a really tight precision and get center mass. But the problem is that in reality, when we fight from these distances, also up to 15 meters, 20 meters, and we have sudden high threat, something we were not anticipated, the stress level is extremely high. And when it's high, our eyes are normally speaking focused on that problem. That's where the red dot sights are really good. Because you guys with the red dot sights, you can see the guy in detail, and you can see the point sort of blurred, and still be very precise. Where with a pistol, I can't really do it. The guys who were doing force on force with us, do you remember with the force on force cards how often people said that they were doing point shooting rather than sighted shooting? You remember that? Thomas, do you remember that a little bit from the courses? Yeah. It's almost like 90% of the people. Yeah. There is also other studies that basically are pretty much consistent with that, right? So with that understanding, we have to understand that in close quarters, yeah, it's nice to shoot dots and stuff with the Kim and Korn. Awesome, cool story, bro, but realistically, this is not how it's gonna be in reality, okay? In reality, however, what I wanna do is to start with point shooting, which means a general shooting in a direction using certain visual reference point on my pistol, go as quick as possible to front sight, meaning only the front of my aiming system, and then, if possible, going between sights,